Good morning. Good to see you all here. We have a couple of baptisms that we'll be getting to very soon here, right at the beginning of the service. Guten Morgen, willkommen. Glad to have you here. As far as announcements are concerned, I thought I would start with facility items. One thing, in an effort to show hospitality to our Northern European guests, we broke the boiler in the sanctuary this last week, so it had that nice kind of crisp medieval edge to the sanctuary today. So hopefully that's a quick fix this next week, but so you know. The new roof is going on in a lovely fashion, and we are identifying all the last little leaks along the way over these last couple of weeks. So scrambling to get that finished. I'd say probably about two-thirds of the planned roof project are completed at this point. And I would say maybe two-thirds of the leaks. So that's where we are on that front. We have made a ton of progress on the courtyard restrooms. They're done, but for putting the fixtures in. And so I went ahead and unlocked those today. So if you wanted to peek in and take a look at the progress, you'd be welcome to do that after the service. As far as other announcements are concerned, this week we are back to our regular programming. So take a look at the calendar online. You'll get a chance to see all of the usual things that are back in action this week. And so please be mindful of that. And as far as events coming up a little further out, I wanted to mention that next Sunday, we have Pastor Christian Chavarria here from El Salvador. He is the assistant to the Bishop of the Lutheran Church of El Salvador, which is a sister church of the Sierra Pacific Synod. And he is an artist and a theologian. He was present at our Senate Assembly this last year, so we're super excited to have the opportunity to have him with us. Erica Kobayashi shared about the Japanese church today during the forum. Next Sunday, he will be preaching and sharing about the church in El Salvador during the forum time as well. As far as other upcoming events, Saturday the 21st, so not quite 2 weeks from now, at 3 o'clock in the afternoon will be the service for Pastor Cora Scheel. 3 o'clock on Saturday the 21st here, and then the reception will be in Brown Hall. It's likely that we will need some help with this service, both in advance of that date and on the day itself. So please keep a close look at your emails to see if there are ways in which you might be able to assist as we get closer. On the 28th, we have a Saturday event, 6 to 8 p.m., Celebrate Grace. It's a fellowship, just fun social time. We will be in Brown Hall as well. So that's a few weeks out. As far as prayer concerns for today, just some people to keep in mind. David, a friend of the Vakel family, recovering from a serious stroke. And also Steve Schumann's father, Jim, who broke his leg this last week, which involved surgery. And so please keep them in mind. In particular, this morning, invite you to remember Doug Hobach and family. His mother is in her last moments, and so we want to remember them in prayer. I think that is it in the way of announcements. I would invite the congregation to grab the red hymnal in front of you. You'll be turning to page 227. 227 in the front, not hymn 227, page 227 in the front, because we are starting with the baptism. So once you've found that page, please stand and turn and face the back and invite the baptismal party to come around to the font. Yeah, and if there are any kids that want to stand a little closer, you're welcome to come right down in here. Come on down. We have the sponsors. You ready for your line? Yeah. Okay. God, who is rich in mercy and love, gives us a new birth into a living hope through the sacrament of baptism. By water and the word, God delivers us from sin and death and raises us to new life in Jesus Christ. We are united with all the baptized in the one body of Christ, anointed with the gift of the Holy Spirit, and joined in God's mission for the life of the world. Amen. I present
Mila Violetta for the baptism.
I present Vera Sophia Wright for the baptism.
Excellent. Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, do you desire to have your children baptized into Christ? As you bring your children to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with responsibilities to live with them among God's faithful people, bring them to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, teach them the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, place in their hands the Holy Scriptures, and nurture them in faith and prayer, so that your children may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others and the world God made, and work for justice and peace. Do you promise to help your children grow in the Christian faith and life?
I do.
And sponsors, do you promise to nurture these ones in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help them live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church?
I do.
And people of God, do you promise to support them and pray for them in their new life in Christ?
We do.
I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God?
I renounce them.
Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to death. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning your Spirit moved over the waters, and by your word, you created the world, calling forth life in which you took delight. Through the waters of the flood, you delivered Noah and his family. And through the sea, you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. At the river, your son was baptized by John and anointed with the Holy Spirit. By the baptism of Jesus' death and resurrection, you set us free from the power of sin and death and raise us up to live in you. Pour out your Holy Spirit, the power of your living word, that those who are washed in the waters of baptism may be given new life. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated. If you want.
I tell you what, go ahead and stand back up. We're helping you stay warm, and this way you can turn and see what's going on.
Mila, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Vera, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give your daughters and sons new birth. Cleanse them from sin and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Mila with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever.
Amen.
Mila, child of God, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit, marked with the cross of Christ forever.
Amen. Amen.
Sustain Vera with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever.
Amen.
Vera, child of God, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the sign of the cross, Christ forever.
Amen.
Mila, Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will have the light of life. Vera, let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and glorify God in heaven.
Let us welcome the newly baptized.
We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world.
Amen. Let's welcome. Now we will sing.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God, our Father, at the baptism of Jesus, you proclaimed him your beloved Son and anointed him with the Holy Spirit. Make all who are baptized into Christ faithful to their calling to be your daughters and sons, and to empower us all with your Spirit through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. You may be seated.
A reading from Isaiah. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. He will not cry or lift up his voice or make it heard in the street. A bruised reed he will not break, and a dimly burning wick he will not quench. He will faithfully bring forth justice. He will not grow faint or be crushed until he has established justice in the earth, and the coastlands wait for his teaching. Thus says God the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and what comes from it, who gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the prisoners from the dungeon, from the prison those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord, that is my name. My glory I give to no other, nor my praise to idols. See, the former things have come to pass, and new things I now declare. Before they spring forth, I tell you of them. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Worship the Lord in his holy temple. Ascribe to the Lord, you gods, ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due God's name. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Worship the Lord in his holy temple. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is upon the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is a powerful voice. The voice of the Lord is a voice of splendor. Worship the Lord in his holy temple. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedar trees. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. The Lord makes Lebanon skip like a calf, and Mount Hermon like a young wild ox. Worship the Lord in his holy temple. The voice of the Lord bursts forth in lightning flashes. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. Worship the Lord in his holy temple. The voice of the Lord makes the oak trees writhe and strips the forests bare. And in the temple of the Lord, all are crying glory. Worship the Lord in his holy temple. The Lord sits enthroned above the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as King forevermore. O Lord, give strength to your people. Give them, O Lord, the blessings of peace. Worship the Lord in his holy temple.
A reading from Acts, eine Lesung aus der Apostelgeschichte. Petrus aber tat seinen Mund auf und sprach: Nun erfahre ich in Wahrheit, dass Gott die Person nicht ansieht, sondern in jedem Volk, wer ihn fürchtet und recht tut, der ist ihm angenehm. Er hat das Wort dem Volk Israel gesandt und Frieden verkündigt durch Jesus Christus, welcher ist Herr über alles. Ihr wisst, was in ganz Judäa geschehen ist, angefangen von Galiläa nach der Taufe, die Johannes predigte, wie Gott Jesus von Nazareth gesalbt hat mit Heiligem Geist und Kraft. Der ist umhergezogen und hat Gutes getan und alle gesund gemacht, die in der Gewalt des Teufels waren. Denn Gott war mit ihm. Und wir sind Zeugen für alles, was er getan hat im jüdischen Land und in Jerusalem. Den haben sie an das Holz gehängt und getötet. Denn den hat Gott auferweckt am dritten Tag und hat ihn erscheinen lassen. Nicht dem ganzen Volk, sondern uns, den von Gott vorher erwählten Zeugen, die wir mit ihm gegessen und getrunken haben, nachdem er auferstanden war von den Toten. Und er hat uns geboten, dem Volk zu predigen und bezeugen, dass er von Gott bestimmt ist zum Richter der Lebenden und der Toten. Von diesem bezeugen alle Propheten, dass durch seinen Namen alle, die an ihn glauben, Vergeben der Sünden empfangen sollen. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand as you're able for the reading of the gospel.
From heaven said, This is my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased.
The Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized by him. John would have prevented him, saying, I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me? But Jesus answered him, let it be so now, for it is proper for us in this way to fulfill all righteousness. Then he consented. And when Jesus had been baptized, just as he came up from the water, suddenly the heavens were opened to him, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and alighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, this is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
You may be seated.
I'd like to invite the children to come down. Good morning. Good morning. All right, I have a question. Have you ever had friends or family come over to your house? Yeah? And what did you do before they came over?
Nothing.
Nothing? Your parents didn't say, clean up your room?
No.
No? Did you maybe vacuum or do the dishes? No? We're getting a yes here. Yes? You clean up a little bit? Yeah. Why do we clean up when people come over to our house?
Because they don't want to see your messy house.
I mean, they probably would still love you anyway. But it's a nice way to welcome people, right? We welcome them by having a clean house, by vacuuming, by putting away our toys. We don't want a guest to come in and trip on our toys, right? Yeah. Yeah. It's a nice way to welcome people into our home. And when they get there, you might say, would you like a glass of water? Do you want to sit down? Right? We want to welcome them into our space and make them feel safe and warm and cozy, right? Yeah. In our story today, we hear about welcoming, but it's not welcoming like a guest into our home. It's welcoming the Holy Spirit, which is kind of wild and crazy. And we hear about a baptism, which we just got to experience, which is pretty cool. And what happened at the baptism? What happened? Yeah.
You put water on their heads,
yeah. And so when Jesus got baptized, that's the story we hear today. When Jesus got baptized, Jesus didn't just get his head wet. He got all the way dunked in the water, which is cool. And maybe a way of welcoming people is cleaning up and showering and like bathing, and so that you're nice and clean when you have guests over. Yeah?
Is the lesson of today when guests come over, drench them with water?
That is not the lesson of the day. Drench people with water when they come over to your house. No, that's not the lesson. Close though. The lesson is that when we welcome people, we prepare. And so Jesus teaches his disciples about a way to prepare for the Holy Spirit. The way we prepare for the Holy Spirit is we worship and we pray. What are we doing here today? Praying and worshiping. And so we are inviting the Holy Spirit. Pastor Matt and Pastor Frederica every Sunday invite the Holy Spirit into our worship. And so we do that in our lives too, and we prepare that by preparing our hearts and our minds for the Holy Spirit. And so we don't probably need to clean up our heart or clean up our mind or vacuum our mind or vacuum our heart. But we can do that with prayer and with worship. And that's how we welcome the Holy Spirit in. And baptism is a way of welcome too. When we welcome someone new into the church, we baptize them. So we got to welcome her into the church by baptizing her with putting a little bit of water on her head. And so we remember today that it's our job to welcome people and to love people and to take care of people and to prepare so that we can be good people who welcome
into the church and into the world and into our hearts. Let's say a prayer. God, we thank you for your love and for the gift of baptism. Help us to welcome the Holy Spirit and welcome others into our lives and find ways that we might love. In your name we pray. Amen. Thanks for coming up.
I forgot one announcement at the beginning of the service that I wanted to make as a part of this word section of the service. Many of you are aware that we have a series that I call Second, Second, Second. So on the second Sunday at the second service, the second reading is shared by a member of the church in their native language other than English. And so this year we have had Japanese, we have had Arabic, we have had Spanish, Finnish, and then this morning, thank you, Philip, for reading in German. We appreciate it.
Our very own Elizabeth Hood introduced me to choosing a word of the year 3 years ago in January 2020 at a women's night out. A word of the year is a word you decide to focus on and to incorporate into your daily life for the upcoming year. Well, 2020 didn't turn out as expected for anyone. And I hadn't chosen one since then, but I wanted a word for 2023. And it came to me last Sunday on my way to church on January 1. My word for the year is holiness. Most commonly, we associate with holiness things that are pure and immaculate. Somehow they are far away, removed. Objects that need to be treated differently. It's about something or someone that deserves veneration. God, for example. God is holy. The word holy comes from the Old English heilig and is derived from hall, which means whole. It was used as a meaning, as it was used in the meaning of uninjured, sound, healthy, entire, complete. I think from our experience as human beings, we can agree that neither of us is entirely uninjured, sound, healthy, entire, complete. Rather, we seem to be the opposite: hurt, defective, prone to injuries and sickness, unfulfilled and broken. We try and we fail. We want to and we can't. We are limited and imperfect. We appear unholy and God is holy. We appear to be unworthy, and God is worthy. We are here, and God is somewhere there. But then there are those moments when we are gifted glimpses of God, of holy moments in our lives. I'm sure we all agree that the seconds after the baptism of Jesus must have been a holy moment. Because, I mean, what else would you call a moment when the heavens open and the Spirit of God descends like a dove and alights on Jesus. And then there is this voice from heaven saying, "This is my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased." Definitely a holy moment. But I would argue that the holiness of the situation already begins before that particular moment. It begins when Jesus decides to go to join the people of Jerusalem and all Judea and all the regions along the Jordan who have been going out to see and hear John the Baptist, this curiosity in camel's hair who's preaching the baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sin on the River Jordan. And the crowd is divided. There are those who just watch and jeer how low the other people must have sunk and how sinful they must be to need to be dunked in the Jordan. And then there are those who feel meant by John's call for a change of heart, for a change of life, a reorientation, who long for forgiveness to start anew. And Jesus, the Son of God, in his first public act, joins the queue to be baptized with them. It is an act of astounding humility and solidarity with humanity. Jesus, God, comes alongside us, even to the point of joining in a rite of repentance and renewal. Here, Jesus proves that he is the Emmanuel, God with us. It is a holy moment indeed, and unlike anything you would expect from the Son of God, humble and self-effacing instead of loud and powerful. Now, Jesus joins queues in line with the old and young, the revolutionary, the traditional, the rich and poor, the pious and the smarty pants, parents and children, the sick, the lonely, the desperate. The line moves slowly. Minutes, hours pass. But finally, Jesus steps into the murky water of the Jordan River. And the holiness of the situation breaks through again in that split second when John realizes who is standing in front of him. He has been proclaiming the one who is more powerful than himself for a while now, and he just knows. This instant of realization, of recognition, of hope fulfilled, of prayers answered, is a holy moment too. But it doesn't take John long to protest. Wait a minute, this should be the other way around. You should baptize me, not I you. But that's just it. Jesus has come to turn our conventional religious ideas on their head. The Son of God is approachable, touchable, and not removed and far away. So Jesus tells John, let it be so for now. And they both submit to the moment. John dunks Jesus in the water of the Jordan, and Jesus, closing mouth and eyes, water running into his ears, freely surrenders his power to John. And still, Jesus remains powerful in his powerlessness, in his giving himself over. Another holy moment. And now here we are. The heavens open and God's voice speak a sentence of sheer appreciation. This is my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased. And I think the well pleased doesn't only refer to the person of Jesus, but also to how he acts and speaks. Humble, in solidarity and humility, in line with those who want to turn the world around into a place for everyone. And in turn, Jesus receives these words of love. You are my Son, the Beloved. Undoubtedly a holy moment. Now we here have been joined to Jesus Christ in the waters of baptism. We are part of the body of Christ. So it's not just Jesus to whom God says, you are my beloved child. With you, I'm well pleased. These words are also addressed to each of us. Personally, without condition. We are always and already God's beloved, not because we have done anything to earn it, but because God's very nature, inclination, and desire is to love. We are deeply loved. And that is so hard to fully grasp. God calling you and me, all of us, my beloved child. I think we can practice discovering holy moments in the ordinary, moments of God's love breaking through into our world. A moment doesn't have to be perfect to have God in it. A moment can include waiting and confusion, like at Jesus' baptism. We don't have to be perfect to experience God. But I think chances are good if we follow the events of our text today. By being humble and practice solidarity like Jesus, lining up with all those wanting forgiveness and patiently waiting. By keeping our eyes open like John for the Messiah. By surrendering ourselves to God's grace and love like Jesus in his baptism. I started to take notes of my moments of holiness in 2023. So far, I have. January 1st, to distribute communion. January 2nd, to go for a walk in cold wind and rain, and to feel the wind on the skin. January 3rd, my daughter Henrietta's sheer joy about completing another level in her swim training. January 4th, to prepare for the coming storm and to acknowledge my own limits. January 5th, to be awoken in the middle of the night by heavy and loud rain on the roof. January 6th, to sit with a dying person and pray together. January 7th, to watch all three of my kids having a dance party to Baby Shark. Even if I don't get to write down a moment every day, I think it's a great spiritual exercise. And who knows, maybe you join me. At least for the season of Epiphany, the few weeks between Christmas and Lent, I invite you to look for God in the commonplace, everyday, seemingly trivial moments of your lives. Just know, you might be surprised where and how God shows up. Amen.
Please stand as you are able.
Religious understanding around the globe, especially in places of ethnic and religious strife. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
For all experiencing winter storms and significant weather events. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
For the Colorado River as it faces continued drought and all places facing a shortage of water. God of grace, for the rebuilding of relationships and open borders between Colombia and Venezuela. God of grace, for refugees, displaced persons, and immigrants who are seeking a better life in a new land. God of grace, for Mila and Vera on the day of their baptism. God of grace, for all who are ill, especially David and Jim, all who are dying, especially Marilyn, and all those we name now in our hearts or out loud. God of grace, for witnesses of faith who died trusting in you, receive our thanks. Guide us by their example until we are gathered with them into your eternal presence. God of grace,
we bring to you our needs and hopes, O God, trusting your wisdom and power revealed in Christ crucified. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. Let's take a moment and share that peace with one another. As you are seated for the offering, just a couple of quick announcements. In the bulletin, you can find QR codes to use for that purpose. The plates will be coming through in a minute. If you're visiting with us today, we'd love to have you fill out one of the welcome cards in your row and put it in the plate. Or yes, of course, there's a QR code for that also. I wanted to mention one thing for our members. We are in the process of putting together a new photo directory. So if you are someone that I think might need a new photo, you can see me in the narthex after the service. If you think the one from 15 years ago is still good, see me, I'll be in the narthex after the service. So. Stand as you are able. Let us pray. God of all creation, all you have made is good, and your love endures forever. You bring forth bread from the earth and fruit from the vine. Nourish us with these gifts, that we might be for the world signs of your gracious presence in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
Indeed, right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. By the leading of a star, he was shown forth to all nations. In the waters of the Jordan, you proclaimed him your beloved son. And in the miracle of water turned to wine, he revealed your glory. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Blessing God, who sent down your Holy Spirit like a dove on your beloved, send your Spirit among us now to sanctify us by your grace. By the power of that same Spirit, make these gifts of bread and wine be for us the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Father of glory, you have opened your heaven and come among us. Bless all who long to be called beloved by sibling or parent or spouse or friend or child, and any who are searching for the love that only you can bring, until we stand in your presence and sing your name and are enfolded in your embrace. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, ever one God. Amen. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
You may be seated as we sing, and as the communion assistants come forward, I would invite you to take a glass from the trays on the front pew. As you come forward to receive the sacrament, please take a glass from the trays that are sitting on the front pew. You'll then receive the bread. There is gluten-free, just to ask us if you need that. The first assistant has wine, the second grape juice, and there are trays in the corner to put your glass before you return to your seat. If you would prefer to receive a blessing, just come forward with your arms crossed. All is ready. All are welcome.
In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee, and was baptized by John in the Jordan, and as he came out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart, and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, my
Please stand as you are able. Let us pray. Radiant God, with our eyes we have seen your salvation, and in this meal we have feasted on your grace. May your word take flesh in us, that we may be your holy people, your glory made known to us in Jesus Christ. Amen. May God, with the cry of a child, accompany your walk in darkness to brilliant light. Amen.
That if you think you belong to the category of people that Pastor Matt wants a picture from, you'll find him in the narthex. Go in peace, share the joy of Christ.